Aside from pluridisciplinary art forms like movies or video games, drawing is the most difficult I've done, by far. What I'm gonna say in this video is based on my rough knowledge of how the brain works, so if you have a better understanding of all this, feel free to share what you know in the comments. In his book, Understanding Comics, Scott McCloud explains how iconic representations of the world help with making memorable imagery. Moreover, the simpler and cleaner the design of a character is, the better is our ability to project ourselves into them. For example, smileys and emojis are extremely iconic versions of the human face, that's why everybody can relate to them. And this is why emojis are yellow. I mean, it's changed recently with different skin-colored emojis, but at the core, the reason for the yellow skin is because nobody's yellow, so it's not iconizing a single part of the population. Scott McCloud even says that when a character is super iconic, we don't experience what they're doing as seeing another person doing it. It's as if it were closer to our inner self. And that makes sense. Here, reading books feels pretty personal, because without visuals to show us what everything looks like, we make our own interpretation of it. So that seems pretty logical that the more iconic and clean a character is in a comic, the more our own interpretation of what this character looks like impacts our experience. The good thing about all this is that we don't need to make photorealistic art to connect with people. The bad thing is that we still do it. But why though? I think grasping a realistic representation of life in comics is important to make them feel closer to real life, to make what the characters go through more impactful. A good way to do it is to keep a certain iconic aspect to the characters and go for something more realistic for the backgrounds, so that the readers can clearly understand the setting. However, it would be weird to have super clean and iconized characters in an ultra-realistic setting. This imbalance would make for either a comical or a creepy atmosphere. We must find a balance between iconic and realistic. Deforming the shape of the human form means iconizing the realistic concepts of anatomy and proportions. Making the eyes bigger means accentuating the emotions of the characters and making them clearer to the reader. No wonder why this trend has stuck through the years. So, let's recap. Iconic designs are good for making relatable content, usually used to create characters that we can project ourselves into. Realistic drawings are good for making content closer to real life, as if we were experiencing it from the outside, which makes it particularly interesting for backgrounds. This creates the setting for the characters to act in. We don't need to relate to the background, but we do need to relate to the main characters at least a little. And when you see it that way, a lot of things become pretty clear. A lot of manga follow this concept. There's often iconic characters in a more realistic setting, and the bad guys are usually drawn more realistically because it makes them less relatable. So, what makes drawing so difficult then? Well, without surprise, it's the realistic aspect of drawing that's difficult. Everybody can draw iconic versions of everything they've seen. Ask a kid to draw a cat. Ask someone who doesn't know how to draw a cat, or just play Pictionary. You'll have roughly the same results. The brain memorizes visual information with patterns, and when you see a cat, it mixes in all the patterns that you see and subconsciously lets you know that it's a cat. These patterns are what you draw when you're asked to draw anything. You'll start with the more iconic patterns like the eyes, the little pointy ears, the four legs and the tail, and that's it, you got a cat. You can be more specific by adding less iconic details like the fur, the paws, or the slit-shaped pupils. This is how our brain works. We naturally can't consciously remember specific visual details that are not important in recognizing the whole. But the brain does remember these details. As frustrating as it is, we just can't access these memories. We only do when we dream or with hypnagogic images, the images we see when transitioning from wakefulness to sleep. If we want to draw realistic stuff, we need to go against the natural functioning of our brain. We know what something looks like, we see it in our head, but when we draw it, well, we have that. We gotta learn to see more than meets the eye. Learning to draw is a matter of adding new patterns on top of the iconic ones we all know. That's why studying anatomy, the skeleton, and the muscles helps so much. If we struggle with drawing the arm, we can study the inside structure of it to learn new patterns that are hardly visible from the outside. This is why skeletal landmarks like the cheekbones or the thing on the wrist are common landmarks for artists. even if we don't know why. And sure, there's also dexterity, muscle memory, and all that jazz, but it's insignificant compared to rewiring our brain to learn in an unnatural way. So, the next time you study anatomy, try and see it like learning new patterns. Thank you for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and see you in the next one. Bye!